Hey guys, it's called Gameplay here, and today I have a matchup Search and Destroy on Rundown for you guys. I'll be using the ACR with FMJ. I'll be using Marathon Pro, Stopping Power Pro, Ninja Pro, Semtex, and Double Stuns. As you can see right now, I'm picking the Intervention, but I'll switch in about 3, 2, 1 now. And so basically how I approach Rundown is every single time I ever play this map, the first round I always rush and I go to the right bridge right here just to catch the other team off guard and to make them back off in the second round. This what I do right here, pull up my G18s, bam, the bomb's down. So because I want to win this game, and I believe I was on like a 23 winning streak right here, I want to keep it going. So what I'm doing is I'm camping the bomb. I'm gonna sit around the bomb. I'm not gonna camp entirely, but I'm gonna stick around the bomb, and I'm going to make sure that the other team does not grab the bomb and plant it, and I do not die. So I have to win. So what I'm gonna be talking about in this commentary is the YouTube community, you guys. So a lot of things, there's a lot of controversy in the YouTube community right now. There's a lot of controversy in playstyles. People are saying that there are certain playstyles in which you have to play. There's people that are saying, oh, you have to rush. There's people saying you have to camp. And what I'm saying is that there's a certain enigma or stigma in this game and how people look at it. People look at other players. So if one camps, a rusher or someone else will say, oh, you're quote-unquote a noob. So I don't really understand this. Sure, sometimes someone will be camping, I'll be like, oh wow, that's kind of annoying, but it's not wrong. This is all opinion based. This game on how you play it is opinion based and how you feel, how much fun you have, and realistically it shouldn't affect your outlook on that person, gamer tag, whatever, PSN ID, on the person that's playing. You shouldn't get mad at them if they're camping, if they're rushing, if they're, let's say, there's another example, hard scoping, quick scoping. Now, before Optic, quick scoping was not really a huge thing. Well, not really before Optic, but if there wasn't any YouTube, there would not be such thing as quick scoping being super popular. Because quick scoping realistically came huge on the YouTube community. And again, hard scoping has become, because of the YouTube community, has become quote unquote gay, because it is, again, quote unquote, apparently noobish. And in how you play the game does not make you bad at it, does not make you good at it. It's how you approach playing with other people and how you adapt to how other people play. So, for example, you are a rusher and there's another person on another team that is rushing. And for 2 straight rounds, you just keep on getting, you two are just colliding. And even if you switch up your routes, you're still colliding and you're dying by him, even though he's rushing you, because he's a better rusher than you, let's just say. And what are you going to do? Are you going to camp? Are you going to not go by your laws? Or, let's just say, it's going to be a religion now. So the outlook of how you play in this game, are you going to go against it and camp? And that would be the smart thing to do. Or are you going to keep on rushing? Are you going to be somewhat hard-headed and play the style that you want people to look at you? So that's really what I'm trying to touch base on right now, and how the YouTube community, not everybody, there's maybe let's just say out of my 5,000 subscribers, there's maybe, I bet there's 200, I'm guessing, maybe more, but you're not bad people, there's nothing wrong with it, but it's just an outlook on that I think people should change, in my opinion, because this is a game, this is not a lifestyle, This is not a something that should change your life on how you play it. It's a game. Everybody plays it differently. It's opinion based. So basically, it just really doesn't make any sense on how people bash other people based on how they play. So another example, Hutch, Optic Hutch, or how he used to be Optic Hutch. Hutch really changed the community on his outlook on how he plays, because Hutch, a Moody Swede, and other Optic people really changed the game. They quickscoped, and people started really enjoying that. Sure, I totally agree, it's very entertaining to watch quickscoping and other people rush, and it's a lot more entertaining than watching people camp. No offense to Wings of Redemption, because he plays tactically. I don't really necessarily call that 100% camping, but he plays tactically, and sometimes he does camp, but it's his playstyle, and there's nothing against him that is wrong about it. So it really is entertaining to other people watching people quickscope and watching how they play, and that's how Hutch, a Moody Swede, Small Beans, who else? Optic Hex, all the Optic members, that's how they got popular on YouTube. And that's just that stigma on how people outlook other people. So, Wings of Redemption, I believe it took him such a long time to get many subscribers. Wings of Redemption is a very controversial person in the YouTube community. And that's what people like in the YouTube community. That's another thing, is that people like controversy. And I'm not one to stick my head out of the crowd and start calling people out and other things. I just like playing the game. And that's just someone's personality, and that's how people maybe look at the game. So controversy is not really something that I'd like to get known on YouTube for. Wings of Redemption did do that. He called out Hutch in the past and that stuff, and that's how he got popular, and that's fine, because that's people that watch his video find that entertaining, and sometimes to an extent I find that entertaining as well. It's fun to watch controversy. You want to see what's happening. Because it's just so intriguing, it makes you want to see it more. And realistically, that's all I want to say in this video. It's more of a video on telling people how my outlook is. That it's been 8 minutes so far, so if you're still watching, you can watch me rape the other team with AC-130, and my end score will end up being 16-1, and I'm just gonna go right now. So thanks for watching, guys, and peace. Keep on watching, keep on subscribing.
One in five, one in five. Oh.